Welcome back, everybody, to Dragunov Gaming. I'm here with Battlefield 3 Campaign. You guys really seem to enjoy the first episode of this, so let's continue right where we left off.
The PLR is reaching out with catastrophe help to all American soldiers. Come out in the open. Hiding will be seen as an act of aggression.
رفتن نمیتونه از یاد دور رفته باشه.
motherfucker hands! Holy shit! Blackburn!
Am I glad to see you? In about half an hour, this place is gonna be every fucking man for himself. Come on, let's get the fuck out of here. Misfit, this is Misfit 1-3. I think I'm almost back at the staging area. I don't know, this place looks real different without any frickin' buildings.
Prove what you have to do. Ospreys are leaving in 5 mics.
I got the door. Come on. Milnet was saying there's riots all over the fucking city. And get this, a coup in Iran. Sponsored by your friendly neighborhood PLR.
Stop me if this is incorrect. Farouk al-Bashir and the PLR seize power in Iran almost the same day as the earthquake. They become a threat. A few weeks later, we send in 50,000 Marines to take them out. We go to war in Iran.
Is this a history lesson?
What part did you play in going after al-Bashir?
That's a broad question.
Well, then I will narrow it down. Your first mission.
Initially, our role was to do BDA after airstrikes in the northern quarter of Tehran.
Battle damage assessment. Why were you doing that?
It was procedure. We were looking for a high-value target fast air was supposed to hit.
So far as I can tell, you don't have a great history of following procedure.
Tell me about your interaction with Lieutenant Colby Hawkins. She was an F-18 pilot?
She? Don't know her.
As you went in, she took part in an airstrike on al-Bashir.
Hawkins, we just got raised to alert one. Plans have changed. We're launching now. CAG says we're special today. We're not on station for some whiskey Delta ground support. DASC is gonna fill us in airborne, but we are flying a strike mission over Tehran into Mehrabad Airport. Elint has sat images. They think they know where al-Bashir is. So, get your fangs out, Hawkins. We're hunting big game today. That's pretty much it. There's Iranian bogeys in the air already. Pucker factor, 9.7.
Flight of two, Angels three, coming off the deck northwest of your position. ATM 88. All right, Hawkins, switch us over to ground attack. 4-6 Reaper 1, we advise our fuel trucks crossing the tarmac. Looks like they're headed for fighters. How copy?
Tracker 2-2, we're lasing targets for you now. How copy?
Roger. Rolling in. Stand by.
4-6, copy. Okay, Hawkins. Switch to infrared. Find them. Keep the tracker.
4-6, reference the main terminal. There's one across the runway now.
Good kill.
Shark 4-6, you have another one near the radar tower. Bombs away.
That's a nice story. I don't see how it connects.
What, do I gotta draw you a map? Al-Bashir was never there. That's why you went in.
Now, we knew he was in Tehran somewhere. He'd gone into hiding.
I see. And until this point, you didn't believe Al-Bashir was affiliated with Solomon? There was no link?
Just what I saw in Iraqi Kurdistan when I saw
Solomon. I've got a question. Al-Bashir was our JFK. We should have left him where he was. You remember saying that?
No.
Who did?
I don't know.
Sure you don't. I bet you don't know who shot your CO either.
Fuck you.
Let's not forget the nature of a little interaction here. This is not a trial. You are guilty. I know how your fucking story is.
We're not here to manhandle him. Let him go. Now, as far as our treatment of him goes, our directives are very clear. I just want to get to the bottom of this, and I want to do it cleanly.
Fine. Tell us how you found the nuke in Tehran.
Alright everybody, that was episode number 2 for Battlefield 3. I hope you guys enjoyed, and drop a like rating down below if you guys did. Comment if you have any suggestions on what I should play. And yeah, just give me any constructive criticism that you guys have. Always open to it. So, thank you for watching.